is there a point where you're blocking that relationship from moving forward?
Hi, this is Peter Kowalke. I'm here today with Laura Lee Wood, a relationship and dating coach based out of Nashville, Tennessee. These people who are not trusting, they can't get over it. How do you start trusting somebody? Let's say you have a client who comes in and they want to date, they want to open their heart, but they've been burned.
Mm-hmm.
What's the process for somebody to start to change that dynamic?
Yeah, so I go back with clients and look at prior relationships and where do we need healing and where do we need forgiveness. And forgiveness of the other person in a relationship and forgiveness of yourself for, you missed some signs and you didn't get out. You blame. There's a lot of blame oftentimes when you've been burned. You blame yourself for a number of things. Mm. And there could be a lot of anger toward an ex. And we can globalize all the bad things that happened in the old relationship and sort of project those onto future relationships. So I really focus with clients on, tell me a little bit about that last relationship. What beliefs did you take out of that relationship? And oftentimes, and I wrote a blog about this, about the things we say when the door slams shut, the arguments. And I have noticed men in particular, I will ask them about the last person they dated and how it ended, and they will have quotes that the woman made about themselves, and they adopt it as their own. So one of the other steps I go through is, what beliefs are you carrying that are not your own, but you've adopted them as your own? So your spouse said XYZ about you, and it was something negative. You've taken that on, and now you feel not good enough, or now you feel like, you're never going to find somebody because you're too complicated. That's what I hear a lot working with my clients. And then you impose that on your current dating life and you just can't get past it.
You live up to it. You become too complicated. You just assume that people can't understand you, basically.
Correct. And so a lot of it's just mindset work, to be honest, and just clearing old blocks, clearing old beliefs, reframing, and creating a new view and perspective of dating. And I have an amazing client I'm working with right now, and it's just been a true pleasure to work with her on a lot of this mindset stuff and to see how transformational it has been in a short period of time.
I hear you, Laura. The belief level is really where the good stuff happens. I can't tell you how many clients will come in and work with us, Laura, whom they want tactics. They want the quick fix. They want the tactic. Just tell me what to do. But then when we get into it, we dive deeper than that. We go into the beliefs. We go into, how am I coming to the situation? Mm-hmm. And that's almost invariably where things change. It's not the tactics. It can be all in the books. As good as this video might be to somebody, it's not the end. You got to do the work, and the work is at the belief level. Ideas are not usually going to get you far enough. You got to work with what's inside. Yeah. So that really is where the transformation comes from, isn't it?
It is.
So when you talk about getting over the I'm not trusting thing, what I'm hearing is a lot of it comes from what you took away from that last relationship. What were the lessons learned? Is what I'm hearing.
Right. And it could be from a series of relationships. It could be from, these short relationships and dating that were only 3 to 6 months. And then something blew up in them. And there's been, a stream of them over the last few years. And so now the wounds are just growing and deepening because this pattern is repeating over and over and over again. And so I try to look and see, what are the similarities in each? And we talk about the man or the woman in each. To see what were you attracted to, why did it end, and is there a point where you're blocking that relationship from moving forward? Like, do you have a time frame in your mind, right, that you decide you can't move past that point? And are you willing to do the work to create a belief that you can have a lifelong relationship?
So thank you for taking the time to talk with me, Laura. I really do appreciate it. It's been really fun. For those who are interested in learning more about Laura and her coaching programs and practice, you can go to NashvilleLoveLifestyle.com. And my understanding is there are some goodies that they'll be able to get when they visit your site and learn more about you. Is that correct?
That is correct.